Let's go to Jesus in Atwater, California on Catholic Answers app. Hello, Jesus in Atwater.
Hi. Thank you, Patrick and Gene, for taking my call, and God bless you for what you guys do.
You too. Thank you.
The gist of my question pretty much is, could it have been possible that St. Peter denied Jesus not because of fear or weakness, but because of God's will in order for his plans to be fulfilled, given that Peter had already proved to what extent he would go to defend Jesus, you know, cutting off the soldier's ear? And if had he been arrested alongside Jesus or had he been also killed, then it would have put kind of like a wrench in his plans, given that he was giving him the keys of his kingdom.
Well, I think this is a situation where we may have a classic both and, because Scripture is pretty clear that Peter denied Jesus because of fear and weakness. That's why, I mean, an illustration of that, and Peter himself thought so, an illustration of that is found in the Gospels when, after Peter has denied Jesus, in Luke's Gospel, if I'm not mistaken, Jesus turns and looks out the window at Peter, and Peter then flees. He leaves the high priest's courtyard and goes outside and weeps. And so he recognizes that he has done wrong, that he's been afraid and that he's been weak. So I would say that he did so through his own fear and weakness. Now, God knew he was going to do that, and God can use even our sinful choices, even our mistakes, to accomplish his goals, and he can bring good out of them. In fact, according to the Catechism, God wouldn't tolerate an evil unless it was part of his plan to bring some good out of it. And you've just named some goods that came out of the fact that that Peter didn't get arrested and didn't get executed alongside Jesus. He was then able to continue his leadership function in the church. Now, God could have achieved those goods even if Peter had not denied Jesus. But as it was, he allowed Peter, through fear and weakness, to deny him, and he still brought goods out of it. So I would say this is a situation where it's likely to be a both and rather than an either or. Also, you mentioned about him proving how far he was willing to go to defend Jesus in cutting off the high priest's servant's ear. That's something that kind of plays an interesting and somewhat more complex role here. Number one, people can have momentary bursts of courage that then they may not be able to sustain. And so even though Peter had previously said, "Oh Lord, if you're going to go to die, I'm going to die with you." And even though he had the courage to cut off the ear of this man, that didn't mean he was going to be able to sustain that level of courage. People can momentarily work themselves up into things that they then don't end up following through on. And in this case, the fact that he cut off the high priest's servant's ear may be one of the reasons that he wasn't able to sustain that level of courage. Because if you read about what subsequently happened, in particular in the Gospel of John, he goes to the house of the high priest, and initially Peter's not able to get in. The doorkeeper won't let him in, but because John, the beloved disciple, was known personally to the high priest, he was let in, and then he was able to get Peter in as well. And then Peter was standing around with the guards that had just arrested Jesus. He's standing around with the guards, warming himself in the firelight, and there is a big risk he's taking here that he may be recognized as the guy who cut off the ear of the high priest's servant. He's in the high priest's own courtyard with the high priest's own guards right there. And so he did have courage to get to that point, but at that point his courage failed him, and part of the reason was fear of being recognized.
All right. Okay, yeah, that puts a good light into what I was thinking.
Great. Awesome. Thanks for that, Jesus. All right, take good care.